Welcome to this WKTV sports presentation. I am Mike Moll, and we're coming to you from Wyoming Lee High School for the annual Stubby Overmire Baseball Card and Collector Show. You can see over my shoulder that once again this year we've got baseball's last 30-game winner and member of the 1968 World Championship Detroit Tigers team, Denny Mclain. And also this year we'll have a new first-time guest with us as Denny is bringing in the 1986 American League Rookie of the Year, 1988 American League Most Valuable Player of the Year, at that time with the Oakland Athletics, Jose Canseco. We'll also be wandering around and interviewing a few of the multi-vendors that are here this weekend. And we appreciate you joining with us. Sit back and we hope you enjoy the show.
Sunday's here and the bacon's on, the eggs are frying and the coffee's strong. Heading for the back porch after breakfast is done, just to feel the warmth of a Sunday morning summer sun. Come out here, darling, sit next to me. I couldn't ask for more. Our life is perfect as can be. Here comes the kids shooting their water guns while I sit here with you in the Sunday morning summer sun. Each day's unanswered prayer, I'm loving every minute. This world has got its ups and downs, but I'm thankful to be in it. God gave us these times to laugh and have fun and enjoy the beauty.
Say hi to the camera.
Well, we've got a longtime vendor here. I know, Tom, you've been here at every one of them. Tom Brooks, and you always have the best seat in the house other than sitting at the table for the autographs.
Yeah, I'd like to be sitting over there, but I'm not famous enough.
No, but you've got an awful lot of nice-looking stuff out here with you this year.
I always try to bring the good stuff for the show. I tell you that. I enjoy coming here. It's a real pleasure.
And we've got a new first-time guest this year, Jose Canseco. I see you've got some of the Canseco things sitting over here, but you said you've already sold some as well.
I will say, Jose, can you see, has been my best card to sell off the table today.
Well, that is great. A very good beginning. We've got an early crowd here. It's a two-day event this year. How do you think that's going to impact on anything?
I think that the people that really want to come to the show are going to be here today, and the people that just love to come to card shows will be here tomorrow.
That's good. It's a different time of year. We're used to doing it right around Valentine's Day, February. Instead, we're here in November. Still a nice day, so we didn't have to worry about the weather or any of that conflict going on. But what do you have that you would like to share with us down here on your table right now, Tom?
Well, the thing I brought today was my 1968 Detroit Tiger autograph bat. And that's this black one here. And it's got all the big names on it. Mclain, Lowledge, Colliff, Kaline, Freeham, Willie Horton, John Hiller, Gator Brown, Stanley, Don Wirt, Tommy Matchek. Really nice bat. It's for sale today.
I have a feeling you're not going to go home with that in your truck after this weekend, Tom.
You might be right.
Man, it's something when you listen to look those names and you look back at it, it sure does not seem like 1968 at that, looking back at that long.
Well, guys, like you and me have been talking about that team forever. It's my favorite team, and unfortunately, a lot of the guys on there are gone, and you're not going to get that again. It's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to...
Absolutely. So, well, Tom, we appreciate it as always that you come out, you join it. It's always for a good cause. Ty puts a good show on, but I know he's got a lot of help from people such as you that are year in and year out.
I try. Thank you so much. Good to see you as always.
You too, Tom. Thank you. Have a great day.
Looking forward to next year.
Absolutely.
All right. Thank you.
Yeah. Well, we're joined by another long-timer at the event, Bill Hamilton. Bill, how's it going today?
Really good, thank you. Enjoying the day again today. It's great to be out here at the school, working this and trying to make some money for the kids in the school. Love it. Brought a few new items today that are different. I brought my Department 56 stadiums that people sort of like. I thought, especially with the Cubs winning, maybe that would be a popular piece for folks, and it's just sort of something different. And that, along with my Barry Sanders helmet, I just wanted to change it up a little bit from just baseball. So, yeah, a few different things today, and again, I'm really enjoying myself. Great day, good weather, like Ty's date change.
Yep, exactly so. As we commented when earlier, we've been usually February, right around Valentine's Day. Instead, right after the World Series, so it's a big topic of discussion. You mentioned the Chicago Cubs. Did you ever think you would be celebrating a World Series of the Cubs?
No, I'm really surprised. Especially when they got down 3-1 like that. That was a great thing for the Cubs, great thing for the city. It just mimics exactly what the 68 Tigers did. So that's just another great chapter of baseball history right there.
Awesome. That's a great point from that point. And you also brought up, I want something to share with the viewers, on this Barry Sanders helmet. We were making fun saying, well, the Lions are winning, so you felt you could bring it out. But what was the other piece of history you told us that I totally had forgotten?
Well, you know, we've had Barry Sanders and had Calvin Johnson recently, and the Detroit Lions have had a number of good players, Billy Sims. Well, Barry Sanders, he's known now. He played against the Dallas Cowboys in 1991 in the playoffs, and that is the Detroit's one playoff win since their 1957 championship with Bobby Lane.
That is amazing, and once you said it, I started thinking, I thought, man, he's right, and you just don't realize that as to what they have been through as an organization.
So many good players, so much talent. It's really unfortunate for the fans. They just haven't put it together.
Yep, absolutely so. Well, Bill, as always, we appreciate you coming out. We appreciate you taking your time to talk with us today.
Thanks so much. Thanks for being here.
Absolutely. Have a great day.
You too.
Thanks. We're joined now by longtime Wyoming Lee Rebel Tom DeGennaro, who this last year took upon renewed role in Wyoming Lee football. And how are things going?
Things are going great. We've changed the culture of the football team. Just simple things like showing up every day and being committed and being accountable. You know, those things came this year, and it was a challenge to build them up, but the kids responded well. So
that's great. And you got a win this year, so you broke a long losing streak. You had to feel good about that.
Yeah, I felt great, you know, but for me, it's not about winning and losing. It's really about training these young men to become great parents in the future, better sons right now, better students in the classroom. That's what it's about for me, and that's what I really hang my hat on. The wins are nice. The losses, you know, they can eat you up. But, you know, when you see a kid 5, 10, 15, 20 years down the road and they are just a solid parent and they bring their little ones to meet you, that's the true victory right there.
And there's an awful lot to be said in losing as well. I mean, especially in today's world.
Yeah, the things you learn from losing and how to accept losing, because as we know, you know, being a little bit older guys, we know that we don't always win in life. And how you respond to those tough times can really, really get you through. You know, that loss on Friday night, I always talked to the kids about, you know, someday you're going to have something really challenge you and you're going to realize that these are blessings. Because it's kind of preparing you for bigger things down the road. Would we love to win more? Of course, because we're competitive as the next guys, but it's not about wins and losses, and the wins will come.
Yep.
They'll come.
Absolutely. And I'm always amazed when we come out to Wyoming Lee. I mean, as we talk about football, we talk about basketball. It hasn't been the greatest record in years past, obviously, but the support that you guys have as you look at the football stands on a Friday night, the number of people that come out, you look at basketball on any night of the week, no matter when it is, the number of people that come out, this community really is amazing.
It's pretty cool. I'll wear my Lee t-shirts around the state, and I'll bump into people in the Detroit area or up in Traverse City that know about Lee High School, or, you know, hey, I graduated from Lee High School back in 1953 or whatever, and, you know, and I still keep up with them, and we see those people in the stands on Friday nights and just supporting Lee High School. It's amazing because we're not small anymore. We got about 500, over 500 kids in the high school right now, but when I started, we had 248, and it's just grown. But in years past, this has always been a small school, but there's so many people who are proud to be Rebels that they carry that for the rest of their lives. It's really neat. I had went to a Hope College game, bumped into a gentleman there who graduated class of 53. He was either president or vice president of Hope College for a while, and his name slips my mind, but he was just so hyped that we brought our football players to a Hope football game to see what the college experience was like. But he was just rattling off all kinds of great things about the Rebels, so it was cool.
And then you've got a huge supporter such as Ty Emmelander that puts this event together. I know he's got an awful lot of help, and Ty would be the first one to tell you that when you talk to him. But what does it mean from your perspective as a teacher, as a coach, as a mentor?
Ty is the ultimate Rebel. Ty and Dennis Grundyke are the ultimate Rebels. And there's been times in the past where Ty and I didn't see eye to eye, and then our egos got in the way of whether it was him or me. But in the last couple of years, we've really become close through our faith and what's best for kids. Ty is always concerned about what is best for kids. And you know, sometimes he has to come talk to me and ground me on certain things too. Hey, Tom, you know, don't get so upset. They're kids, you know, and because we forget that at times. We forget that, you know, you're dealing with a 16, 17-year-old in a man's body.
Yep.
And you think, why isn't he acting like a man? Well, he's 16, 17 years old, you know. Just the support. Ty runs our 4-5-6 program for us, and he doesn't charge a penny. And that's a ton of work, and he does a fantastic job at it. And he's at all our games, and he stops in the practice, and he's just a great supporter. He doesn't say much, but I know that he's there, and I can look over and he's like, yeah, you're all right. Yep. You're doing good, you know, so that's cool.
Yep, absolutely. So very well said. Well, Tom, we appreciate the time. All the best to you and your football team, but all the best to Wyoming Lee student athletes and administration. It's a great event, and it's always fun to come out here.
It's a blast. And Mr. Mclain coming in all the time to support the kids. And this year we got Jose Canseco. A few years back we had Bob Feller here. And plus, you know, I go to a lot of the shows around town because this is my hobby. This is what I do when I get bored to collect cards. But you know, seeing the other guys that collect and that little fraternity that we have is pretty cool, too.
Absolutely. Well, thanks, Tom. Have a great day.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Well, we're with another one of the vendors here, actually looking over Denny McLean's table. Chuck, how you doing this morning?
Not too bad. Just trying to help out the school.
There you go. Absolutely. He's got some pretty good-looking stuff. We were looking at the shirt down here. Is this something you do all the time with Denny? Do you go around with him or just in the area here?
I go, like, on the weekends with him. I got kids at home, so I try to keep busy doing plumbing and stuff.
Okay. Is it always, I mean, this event, I don't know, if you haven't been here before, I don't believe.
No. Okay. I ain't been here. This is the first time here.
Okay. I know Denny does a lot of events throughout the course of the year and everything. How does this compare to other events that he's doing?
Oh, this is pretty good. Yep. This is definitely up there. You guys got a good crowd here today.
Yeah, it definitely is. It's the first time it's been into a two-day event. It's usually just a Saturday, and they moved it from February into November and made it into a two-day event. But we've got to take a look. If you can tell us anything about this shirt that he's got down there, this jersey he's got down there, that is pretty special.
Yeah, that's a Denny Mclain jersey with all his stats, errors, he signs it all front and back when it's all done. These go for $75 here today. He's got numerous stuff in boxes here. We got bats, stuff from the World Series from 68. We got the CD movies from 68. Every picture of him and Mickey Mantle, which is Denny's idols. Mickey Mantle gave him his 535th home run.
Yeah.
We got all kinds of cool stuff here for everyone today.
Well, there is an awful lot of good stuff in here as you look at it, and I know he's got more on the table up by where he's signing. So we appreciate you coming out, and we appreciate you taking time to talk with us, Chuck.
Oh, no problem. Anything to help the kids out.
All right. Thank you very much. Have a good weekend.
You too.
Thanks.
Took my sins and all of my sorrows when you gave your life on the cross. You loved me first, you opened my eyes, your resurrection made it possible for me to sing. You did it all, you're the only reason I'm accepted at the Father's throne. You changed my heart, and I want the whole world to know. You're an endless flowing river of love and truth. It's not about me, it's all
Denny,
about
Denny, and as always, we cannot thank you enough for all of your participation year in and year out and making the trip over here to Wyoming, Lee.
Well, we got to get Ray back one more time.
Absolutely.
You know,
so
got to bring him back one more time. And so you guys just need to get him well and get, kick him a little bit and get him over here, because not everybody should have to eat these hot dogs. And Ray should have to eat, because if Ray eats one of these hot dogs, he will never die.
Hi, Danny.
Hi, sweetie. How are you?
We'll put that on tape. Want a picture of that?
I don't why are you playing with my head?
We certainly appreciate your coming every year.
And we appreciate you too, Ray.
Well,
now that you got your own TV show, The Blacklist, I mean, it doesn't get any better than this.
Now the Blacklist, I don't know what you mean by that, but I don't think it's good. So, thanks for being
You're
here.
You're very welcome. It's always good to see you. I'm glad I drove you out of retirement to come here.
Okay.
All right? Because I heard the other guy's not very good anyway.
Yeah.
Is the other guy here?
Yeah, he's here.
Thank Has he you. Got a gun?
No, he no doesn't gun? Have okay. a gun, right. but he's got a pretty good fist.
Does he? Well, Dean.
All right.
Get Dean over here.
Thanks.
I was wondering if that was a reflection on me compared to him, so I'm glad you put it that way.
You don't make the hot dogs, do you?
I'm not answering anymore.
Okay. All right.
All right, Danny, thank you very much. All the best.
One thing about the hot dog, if you put enough relish on it, you'll kill what's in it.
Thanks, Danny. Appreciate it. All right, we are now joined by one of the recipients that gets to see what this gathering does for him. Center fielder, I understand, on the Wyoming Lee baseball team, Jose Cruz, a senior here at Wyoming Lee?
Yes.
How many years have you been coming out to see this event?
I've been here for 2 years, because last year was my first year.
Okay. As a student athlete that sees the benefits of this afterwards, what does something like this mean?
It means so much to us. We get a lot of stuff for our baseball field. We get new jerseys, new bats. It just benefits our baseball program a lot.
Absolutely so. And many things that I'm sure without it, especially with the tight budgets that schools are under these days, you would not be able to do otherwise.
Yeah, that's correct.
From Ty Melander, I know he's a coach. What does he mean to you as a student athlete?
He's like a father to all of us. He's a great coach. He's probably one of the best out I love him. He's a good man.
Excellent for the opportunity and the community here. Ty is always so concerned. You see so many postings about things that go on around here. And now, from the point of view, you've got Jose Canseco here for a first time. You saw Denny Mclain last year with your first event. What does that show to you as a young athlete from that point?
It shows that once you can make it out, you can still come back and benefit your community. You know, they're very good players, and for them to come do this for us, it means a lot.
I imagine so. Well, Jose, we appreciate the time, and I'm sure you've got a winner of workout as you prepare for baseball come next spring.
Yeah, we're going to start working out next month.
All right, good deal. Well, thank you very much, and all the best to you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Well, we're joined now by Dave, the superintendent here at Wyoming Lee. Dave, this has got to be a fun thing to be able to look at from your position and knowing what all of this is going for.
Yeah, you know, this is the 11th year this has been going on, and it's just been great. It's always great to have Denny Mclain support. He's been here, I think, all those years, and it really shows. I couldn't find a parking place to get in here today, so it's a great turnout and good for Lee Rebel baseball and Lee Rebel in general.
Yeah, absolutely. So with it going to a two-day event this year, it has gotten to be so big. We've talked to a couple other people, and they said they'd go to multiple shows during the course of the year, and this is one of the, if not the biggest one, that they're a part of.
Yeah, Ty Emelander really works hard all year long to make this a success, and it's always great to see the turnouts. Of course, I'm a hockey fan, so I'm kind of looking around for some hockey things, but there's a little bit of everything here, as you can see from right here, so I hope more folks come out this weekend.
Exactly. So from the point of view of the position that you're in as superintendent of schools, an event like this, what exactly does it mean to you and your student athletes?
Well, a couple of things. First of all, it brings a lot of folks in here who normally wouldn't visit our school district or our schools. They find out a little bit about us and while they're here. But at the same time, you know, money's tight in schools, and this really helps our ball programs out quite a bit year-round.
Yeah, and I'll tell you what, I've been to a lot of schools and worked with a lot of administrators, but there are not too many people like Ty Emelander around in these school districts.
No, and he just started working for us full-time, and we're really excited to have him doing that because the guy really puts his heart into Lee High School and the kids here.
Absolutely. Well, we appreciate the time. As always, it looks like another successful event. And the best to you and your school and your student athletes during the course of this year.
And thank you, and thanks for always coming out and covering this for us.
Appreciate it. Have a great day. Well, we're here with Jane Overmire, daughter of Stubby Overmire. As we look at this event once again, Jane, what a success.
Oh, I'm pleased, and Dad would be so pleased to see the turnout and to know that, number one, that someone remembers his name, and number two, that, you know, we're creating an atmosphere for these student athletes here, and we're donating money and allowing these kids to be successful, and I think it's a fabulous turnout, and I think it's just a wonderful event, again, the 11th year.
Exactly. Yeah, we say that all the time. I mean, the community here, it's been commented on by so many that we have interviewed and done, you know, talks with around this arena today, the vendors and the people that are in here. The Wyoming Lee community is just amazing with things like this.
Oh, I think they're great, and thank heavens for Ty Emelander and his group. Works tirelessly to make sure that this is a successful event every year. Can't say enough about Denny Mclain, who's been here, you know, with bad knees and a bad foot, and he shows up and he does a heck of a job. And I met Jose Canseco for the first time. I thought that's wonderful for him to be here. And this event has really evolved into something that's wonderful. And again, like when you say about the community, I think it is a very, it's a wonderful community event, and I think with the kids involved, the high school kids involved, it does, it trickles down into the community, and they're proud of the school, they're proud of their efforts. I can't say enough about it.
Yeah, we see some of the student athletes, the baseball players and basketball players and others around here as well, that they see this coming up through the system. As you said, the 11th straight year here. So if you're a senior now, you're looking at basically every year that you've been in school, that it's been this. And the part that they get to play and what they see from it is amazing.
I think it's wonderful. You know, our schools in Michigan, and this is most likely nationwide, the things, financially, we get strapped. And the things that get cut are your art, your music, your physical education, your athletics. And some of these kids, their success point is in athletics, yeah, or is in art or music. And when you start cutting those things, we're already setting them up for failure. We're not allowing them to feel successful, and if a person doesn't feel successful, or a student, they're not coming back. And what we need to do is set them up for success. And by donating money, by having events like this that creates more revenue in the athletic department, it allows you, okay, if before you only had 15 uniforms, now maybe you've got 35 uniforms. And so more kids can participate and more kids can feel successful. And again, that trickles down to the community and it keeps the kids in school, it keeps their interest up. So I think it's wonderful.
Yep, there's too many options these days that are on the negative side for the young people to get involved with and the old people alike, but especially a student, that if you don't have something like this that you know you can build on and you can be a part of a program, there's too many bad options out there these days.
There are too many options, bad options out there for the kids. And an event like this, some of these kids, the responsibility of helping to sell shirts, helping to make sure that Denny, Mclain and Jose Canseco have a cup of coffee next to them. I mean, that's giving them a responsibility, and I think it really shows in the community. And I'm proud to have been a part of it. I didn't go to school here at Lee, but I know my dad would be thrilled. Yeah. He would be thrilled.
Absolutely, it is. It's always a great event. Jane, we thank you for the time. We thank you for the use of the name and everything else that is a part of it and everything you have been a part of in this program as well.
I felt like this year I really didn't participate enough, but I'm anxious to see it continue on in the years to come.
Yep. Thank you very much, Jane. Good to see you as always.
Nice to see you too. Thank you very much.
Hi, Amanda Evlander here with Erica Grundyke. Oh yeah. Erica Leon. I'm sorry. She's been married for 2 years to Jose Leon. So I heard you played in a I heard you played in a softball league in Moline, Michigan this year. Tell me about that.
You were on the team. You were our pitcher.
Who was your coach?
Ty Emelander.
That's cool. He's a good guy. By the way, speaking of Ty Emelander, he's the one that puts all this together. What are your thoughts on this event?
On the event?
On everything.
On everything.
Well, to me, the event, I don't want to do this. This is so awkward, Amanda. Come on. Can we cut this for real, for real? We need to get.
Hey, I thought I was doing a pretty good job.
All right. We're joined now by a couple of the daughters of the organizers of the event. Erica Leon on my left, Amanda Emelander on my right. How are you doing?
I'm doing good. How about you?
I'm doing well. Thank you. How about yourself, Erica?
Doing great. Happy to be here.
There you go. You've been out to this event for many, many years. You've seen all of the influences it has on everything. What does it mean to you?
Yeah, is this the 11th year, I believe? Great to be here. I love coming out and seeing everybody. Today, this year is a big year, having Jose Canseco here. So it kind of, it's a new spark in the mix, and it makes it exciting to see in the next years what will happen. If we can get him here, we can get a lot of big people here and just let this event just keep growing. And that's what it's about for the kids, having everybody come out and raising the money. And the bigger the names, the more, more exactly money we can make for the program. So it's great.
Absolutely. Amanda, what are you doing these days? I haven't talked to you for a while. What's happening in your life?
I'm working a lot. I'm gonna probably go back to school next fall.
Okay.
And but other than that, like, I'm just working.
Where are you looking at going back to school?
Probably CC, just for the time being, and then from there, yep, we'll go on.
Absolutely. Still playing ball at all or not?
We played in the Mclain league this summer, and that was eventful. We played against grown men.
Okay.
So.
More than anything.
You played in it as well?
Yes.
What position were you playing?
Second base.
Okay.
And she pitched for us. It was kind of cool because we usually play like against Kelvin Christian and stuff during when we were in school.
Sure.
And we actually got to have them on the team. We had the best third baseman Kelvin's had in a long time was actually on our team and got to play for us. And she was getting married this fall. And
okay.
So it was kind of cool to, you know, reunite with some of those girls and actually play on the same team.
Right, in a different aspect.
Against, yeah, and it was fast pitch softball against guys. So it was interesting.
Okay, I got to ask you, I'm sure you got some looks when you were striking out some of the guys, didn't you?
I was kind of scared. I thought I was going to get like a line drive to my face, but it wasn't as scary as I thought after we started, but they're very competitive. Like, they would, yes.
They didn't really like us being in the league.
I'm sure they did not. I mean, I played softball for many years, not fast pitch, but I mean, I could understand that from a guy's point of view that, you know. And how old are all of the players?
There were some on there that were probably like 19 all the way up to 60, 70, right? There was one guy, how old was he?
You would probably. We played against like a 65 and up team.
Okay.
So, and that was pretty, that was fun. That was a. We won two games. That was one of them.
Okay, that's what I was going to ask was, how did you do overall?
We were like 2-8. Yeah, we don't even know how many games there was. It was, so we were 2-whatever. And then we won our last game and we went 11 innings. Or it was either 10 or 11 innings. So that was pretty fun.
Did you throw all of them?
No, we had another girl that would pitch every... Like, sometimes I'd pitch half the game, then she'd come in. We'd switch it up just depending on the day, so.
Absolutely. When you say you're going back to school and everything, will you look at playing sports at that point or don't know yet?
I mean, I would love to play softball again, but at the same time, like, I'm working and stuff like that. So it'd have to be a spur-of-the-moment thing and, like, see where we're at that time.
She says she's doing nothing really, but she's raising a daughter, which is a lot of work. So
that's exactly what I was going to ask. She's how old now?
She's a year and a half.
And you've got any?
2.5-year-old daughter, Madeline.
I was thinking that there was hanging out. I remember last year or the year before running around out here a lot.
Yep, they're playing together in the other gym. So
there you go. It's a great bond from that point of view. As you said, you two have known each other for how long?
Well, before we were even born, our dads were good friends. Yep. And from there on, you know, since we were little, we've played softball since we were babies at Pioneer Park, and from there just grew up together, and she came over to Lee, so we went to school together and played ball together and everything, did everything together.
So there again, it's another case, as we've been talking all day long, about the close-knit of the Wyoming Lee community and the families as they're raised up through there, as to the true family that you feel when you're a part of it.
Yeah, that's one thing like I liked about the school, and too, like when I was looking at colleges, I was looking for small communities because like that's just what I'm used to. I went to Hudsonville when I was in middle school and elementary, and I didn't know half the people. Like we were split into two separate groups. It was like Summit and Element, and you only knew some of the people in Element, and you had no idea of anybody in the other group. And it was, so that's why I like the small-knit school, because you could just like walk up to people and be like, hey, how you doing? Even if you haven't seen them in so long, because like it's so personable. So.
Absolutely. Well, I know you're both always nervous and not real fans of being interviewed, but as always, we greatly appreciate the time.
Thank you
very much, Erica. Amanda, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for letting me host.
Well, we've got somebody here that's probably pretty happy as they've got the Chicago Cubs jersey on after this last outcome of the World Series. Mark Dornbos. Mark, how are you doing this morning?
Good, thanks. How are you?
I'm doing well. Thank you very much. What brings you out today here?
It's a great show, a great event. This is the 11th year now.
I think I've been here for everyone so far, and one of the things that makes it so good is that the money goes to charity, and it's a very worthwhile cause.
Absolutely so, from that point of view. In today's, you know, it's all about me. It's great to see Ty Emmelander putting another one of these together in the Wyoming Lee community and vendors coming out, and exactly like you said, from that point of view, it's wonderful.
He donates his time. It goes to the baseball team and basically charity. I think years ago he reached out to Denny Mclain, who's on board, and comes every year to sign autographs so he can raise money for charity. And I've lived and worked in this area almost basically all my life. There's a lot of poverty and kids are disadvantaged and they don't have much. It's a good cause and a great program and a great show. Guys come from around the state, including Southeast Michigan, so they can display at this show. It's a great event.
Absolutely is. And you know, we've been out to it for multi-years now in a row, and it's to a two-day event this year. As we've heard, it's one of the largest, if not the largest, card shows in West Michigan. Do you do a lot of shows yourself?
When I can, yeah. And I think the reason they've gone to 2 days now is just because it's been so successful in the past.
Yep, absolutely. Cannot blame them for that at all. Chicago Cubs, you had to be happy.
That was fun. I want to go back and do that again. That was a good World Series, and Game 7 was the best.
It was. You had two teams, and I think people really were rooting for either one. If you didn't have your favorite, if it wasn't Cleveland or it wasn't Chicago, I think people were happy with whoever won just because it broke such a streak.
What else can you say? Go Cubs.
There you go. Well, Mark, we appreciate the time. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Wow, we're joined here. We've got a pretty special picture in front of us here. You can see Jose Canseco. Who's the other young gentleman in there, though?
The young gentleman is my son, Kyle Kleiman. He works for the Fresno Grizzlies, and Jose travels around and does home run derbies, and my son was selected to catch the home run derby. So he got a picture together, and I want to get it signed for him.
Absolutely. Does your son have any clue that you have that picture here with you today?
No clue at all. It's a Christmas present.
Oh, that's great. I hope you can get it signed. That's a wonderful thing. And he just showed us real quick the ring from the AAA championship team as well.
Yes, my son, as I said, worked for the Fresno Grizzlies, and they won the AAA World Series last year, the year with Correa and Bregman and that, and he gave me the ring.
That is fantastic. Well, I hope you are successful in getting the signature you're looking for. I'd be shocked if you didn't. I'm sure it will be a fantastic Christmas when you give it to him.
It's going
to
be a great day, yes. Thank you very much.
Thanks for talking with us. Yep. Appreciate it. Well, we are here with Lee Lamberts, and Lee, you have a very special picture in your hands there. Can you tell us about it?
Yeah, my son grew up, for some reason, he started liking Jose Canseco when he was a little kid, when my son was a little kid. And it might help the fact that my wife is Cuban, and he was always, you know, gathering Jose Canseco cards and stuff like this. And well, I work for the Holland Sentinel, so I can get media passes once in a while. So I said, let's go down to Detroit. Oakland's playing. It was a warm summer night, probably 1990, 1991, something like that, because he was only about 8 years old at the time. So I'm out on the field. Canseco's hitting balls off a tee. And when he was done, I said, I'd like to introduce my son. Can you look over there and wave at the little kid in the green shirt? He goes, bring him out here. So I went over and pulled my son over the railing. Security guard came over and said, you can't do that. Canseco put his hand on the guy's chest, said, he's with me. So we're standing at the edge of the dugout. Takes my son inside the dugout. Jose Canseco's on one side. Tony La Russa's on the other side. And my son, his eyes are just like moons.
Oh, I bet.
So I said, let me get a couple pictures. He said, hold on. So he picked him up, carried him out to the top step of the dugout and said, okay, fire away. So I brought that home, got it enlarged and obviously matted and mounted. The original plastic is still on because my son's been taking good care of it. And I said, you know what? Someday we'll bump into the guy and we're going to get this autographed and it's going to be a family treasure for you and me. Well, someday is here.
Wow, that is a great, great story. And as you can see, it's the old Tiger Stadium. It certainly is not Comerica Park, so you were at the friendly confines already where you were right on top of the players.
Exactly. And the people in the background had some very choice words for my son's favorite player. You're taking your picture with that snot-nosed little kid, and you won't sign us autographs. They started calling him names. He said, that's why.
Unreal. Well, that is a great story. Thank you for sharing it with us.
Well, thank you for letting me share it. I can't wait to meet him and say hello.
I bet. I bet so. Thank you very much.
There you go, sir.
Who's the little kid? Where is he?
That's my son. He's 35 now.
What we got, old quick? Unbelievable.
He was hoping to put two.
Didn't want the son.
Two Jeff G-E-O-F-F.
I forgot a good spot for this.
I wonder if...
You want the fat one?
I wonder if silver would look good on that.
Whatever.
Silver, let's get that going right there. Is that okay with you?
That's fine. Whatever works.
Okay, just let it dry, but I think it'll look really good.
Oh yeah. Took him down to the ballpark. You were doing batting practice, and told you to wave at the kid. You said, "Bring him out here." So sat him down in the dugout, chatted with him.
Well, there you go. Show him what he looked like 30 years ago, whatever it was.
Thanks again.
All right, take care. And here's your ticket, sir. You have a great day, okay?
Thanks.
Well, welcome to a first-time guest here at Wyoming Lead, the 1986 American League Rookie of the Year, 1988 Most Valuable Player of the Year, then with the Oakland Athletics, Jose Canseco. Jose, welcome to Wyoming Lee High School.
Great being here. It's kind of cold, but I'm coming from Vegas where it's been 110 the last month or two, but... I welcome the weather change.
There you go. It's that time of year. It's better than we used to do. We usually do these in February. That really would be an unwelcome change for you.
I heard that usually in February and it's snowing. It's extremely cold, so I'm glad they did it this time of year.
Exactly. So is this the type of thing you've been doing lately? Do you go around and do a lot of shows, or what keeps Jose Canseco busy these days?
You know, it's funny. Since I can remember, I was a baseball player. We've been doing these kind of shows. Lately, when I've been retired, I do a lot of these appearances. A lot of them have to do with golf events, poker events, home run derbies, regular speaking engagement appearances. So I stay consistently busy doing this, yes.
Yep. Well, that's great. We appreciate you taking time out of that schedule. How did you get hooked up with Denny Mclain?
You know, I met Denny, less than a year ago around there at another autograph show. And we spoke briefly. He told me he would like for me to appear at one of his charity events that he actually does. He contacted me, we spoke, and here I am.
Well, that's great. I know it's appreciated. It's always good to have a new face come in with us, but especially one with the stature that you have had. I know you're very familiar. A lot of people relate back to everything with you, and you're looking good and hopefully feeling good. Health is good and everything.
Health is great. I'm 52. I stay extremely active, you know, working out. Like I said, I do a lot of events, a lot of traveling, a lot of softball. And golf and so forth. So I think as long as you keep moving forward, you eat right, you work out, you can fight that aging process off somewhat.
In other words, I made a wrong turn someplace. Is that what you're politely trying to say?
You've been at Dunkin' Donuts a little too much. We're going to get you on a diet.
Well, you look at the stature of baseball and everything. I know you had a bobblehead night this year back at Oakland for your Rookie of the Year year. That had to be kind of fun to go back to.
It was fun. I think the first time I was invited back was for the 25th anniversary of the 89 World Series.
Okay.
So that was exciting to come back. You know, after writing that book, Juice, I didn't know, you know, how the fans were going to acknowledge me.
Sure.
But I got a standing ovation. It was great.
That's great.
And, of course, this year, the bobblehead night, which bobblehead was pretty cool.
It was.
They made something kind of accurate of my days with the Oakland A's. Had a lot of fun then, and I'm just looking forward to building my relationship with the Oakland A's and MLB.
Yep. Well, that's a great. I've read many things to where you felt like you have been kind of slighted after everything that went on, and that would be great if you can pull something like that and they invite you back for those type of things. That's got to feel welcome again.
It's been a process. It's been a slow, ongoing process, but
sure,
it's definitely moving forward, yes.
Yep, absolutely. Well, I know there's a long, long line out there that's waiting to see you and meet you and get autographs from you, but an event such as this, I know you say you do a lot of them. It's the first time here. It's the 11th annual. Ty Emelander puts it together with an awful lot of help. He certainly couldn't do it without people like you coming in.
It's a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun. My first time here. Denny was here already signing. I see him sitting down, and maybe a couple people in line for me, but
yep.
We're going to do the best we can. It's a great place, huge auditorium here, the school. So we'll see how much money we can raise for this.
There you go. I can tell you there's more than just a couple people waiting for you, so we'll let you get to it. We greatly appreciate the time and all the best to you, Jose.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. With somebody that really doesn't need an introduction, anybody that's watched this event from all of the years past. Vern, how many have you been at? Have you been to all of them?
How many have there been?
This is, they're saying 11, but I think it was 11 in the spring, so I think it's like 11 and a half now.
It's the first one.
Okay.
Yeah, I came for the first one to see what it was like, and then I came after that. So I came every year since that time. Yeah.
Okay. You've got, we always comment on your bobblehead display especially. You always have a great collection there. But we've been talking all morning about the Mickey Lolich one that we don't remember him looking quite that thin during his playing days. I think they were being nice to him.
He has lost like quite a bit of weight since they made this. Yeah, I'm waiting for them to make a Denny Mclain one.
Yeah.
You know?
Yep.
Yeah, that'd be kind of cool. And yeah, he's lost a little weight. Pretty cool, though, isn't it?
It is. I'm looking at the other ones you got up there. I see Al Kaline. And
I don't like him in the face either, does it too much. But anyway, it's kind of cool, yeah. But people buy them. I sold 10 of these this morning.
Have
not,
really?
Not Lolich, but bobbleheads.
Wow.
Yeah, last week I sold a dozen in Allendale, but 10 of them today. People are still looking. I got a lady that's going to actually offered me a bunch of them for a price. I haven't seen her back here yet, but I can't, really can't hardly keep them.
Yep.
They people like them. They like the bobbleheads. Hmm.
So you do a lot of the shows then during the course of the year, Vern?
I probably about 10 inside during the year. In the summertime, I go to Trufant and sell outside with Ken Vanderslick down the line here, and we have a good time out in the fresh air, and there's different clientele there.
Yep.
The locals, but you also have a lot of cottage people, outside state people that come. Yeah. So I enjoy that. It's just a good day to be out in the fresh air.
Yep.
You're done in the morning and go home in the afternoon.
There you go. Absolutely.
Well, it's a good show. It's a good cause.
Yeah.
You know, I know Ty works hard to put it together, and obviously Denny has helped him quite a bit.
Right.
So, and you guys have been faithful too with this, haven't you?
Yeah,
for a few years.
It definitely has been. I think this is my fourth year being here, and I know they were here before I got started.
And the cameraman, he's been around forever, hasn't he?
Good old Gary Vandevelde, you bet he has. Nobody better.
Coach is a pretty regular guy, too, isn't he?
He is, and we got Tom earlier on an interview, too, so we're getting all of them here. There's another shot of Tom DeGennaro.
Clementi's. I haven't found a Clementi bobblehead yet, but... It's more of a social outlet for me. I like to come. I talk too much. That's the problem. It takes a while to get my stuff set up when I talk a lot.
Yeah. Well, that's a sign of having a good time and doing it then.
I enjoy it. Yeah.
Well, Vern, we greatly appreciate the time today as always.
Thanks for your work. Appreciate it. Thanks for the work here. Yep.
Good to see you again.
Good to see you again.
Pull out the album, go back to the start. Family will always be part of my heart.
Well, we're joined by the organizer of this event in the 11th year. Actually, 11 and a half, I guess, if we wanted to be technical. And I think February was 11, and we're coming back in November. Ty Emmelander. Ty, another great job.
You know, it's I'm the organizer, but it's the workers. Last night, the Grundyke family was here till, you know, 10 o'clock at night. Their whole family was here. And people, you know, I hope nobody ever realizes that I don't appreciate and understand that, you know, if it wasn't for the help and the effort of people, I couldn't do none of this. It's just I get to kind of be the spearhead. Sometimes I get the praise for it, but really, when this has to all be picked up and shut down, if I had to do it by myself, I'd be here for about 3 days.
Yep.
So it's there's so many people that help. I mean, Tammy Schaefer couldn't make it this year, but there's enough cheese broccoli soup to feed me till next Tuesday here, so which is awesome.
Yeah, and you hear, you know, we talk to the different people. We talk to the superintendent and one of your coaches, Tom DeGennaro, and just the amount of gratitude and appreciation that the entire community, not just your athletes, as we talked to one of them as well, have for this event. It's kudos to you and your entire team across the board.
Oh, yeah, my players work hard. The girls' softball players are here helping out. It's it's a fun event, you know. I mean, it's pretty cool to get to meet these, you know, me being a baseball fan my whole life. It's such a bonus. Last night, I'm riding in the car listening to Jose Canseco talk about how his approach was against Roger Clemens in Boston at Fenway versus if he was playing him in Oakland. Hmm. And it's just pretty neat listening to that kind of stuff. And you know, Denny, I've been all over with Denny. I've went with
him. It's not hard to do with Denny.
Denny is Denny's got stories, you know, that just never end, and they always seem to get a little stronger and a little better as I hear them. They don't get boring.
Well, we've got, as we said, Jose Canseco, first time event for him coming in. Huge draw with him out there this morning.
Oh yeah, I mean, you probably will never see Jose here in West Michigan again, especially at this time of year, because this is freezing cold for him.
He said that when we interviewed him.
I couldn't believe what a mammoth of a man he is. I mean, I always seen him on TV as a big, strong baseball player, but I didn't realize he's about 6'5". When I seen him walking down out of the airport, I was like, oh my good Lord. Big man, but and he's very proud of his home runs. You should go, people out there should go on YouTube and look at his some of the home runs he hit back in the day. It's just amazing how hard that man could hit a baseball.
Yep, absolutely. So,
yeah, you've got the event. You've got all the people. A two-day event this year, so it's expanded into that. I know I ask you this every time we get together. Did you ever in your wildest imagination dream it would get to this?
No, I really – it originally was just going to – the first couple years was just a memorabilia auction. And kind of a little bit of my thought, Mike Donovan, we talked about it a few times, our teacher that can't make it today. He just had a baby and there's some issues going on at home. And we just he couldn't be here today. And we talked about making it a card show. And we said, okay, let's do it. And 1 year, after year one, it was pretty much it took off. But Denny's a huge part of it. I mean, I like to say, he's a straw that stirs a drink in this thing. He lined us up with Jose this year. He's been here 11 years in a row, you know, and I mean, people still are out there buying Denny's autograph, and you guys know as well as I do, he's a very entertaining man.
Yes.
He's a fun guy to talk to and hang out with.
Absolutely is. Yeah, you know, and he gives all the credit to you, saying it's all 100% on you and you organize it. But I know for a fact that he is as well, because I saw your posting on Facebook probably 3-4 months ago that Denny had outdone himself and gotten Jose with this. So he's obviously looking out for it all the time, too.
Oh, Denny's, me and Denny just become really good friends. I mean, his wife, who can't make it, and she's struggling with some health issues, just she's a saint, and we become very good friends. Our families, the Grundyke family and Denny, we become very tight.
Mm-hmm. Well, we're doing this at a different time of the year, as we have commented several times during the course of the day. Instead of February, we're at November. At the end of the World Series instead of at the start of spring training. What do you think of that World Series?
You know, I'll be honest, I'm John Hess over there listening in probably. He knows I never really cared for the Cubs. And what really bothers me about the Cubs winning is I think now that makes the Detroit Lions the worst franchise in existence. So it used to be the Cubs. So now me as a Lions fan, I got to be a fan of the worst franchise, because we are the most jinxed one now.
And I'm laughing because I'm looking over at John. He's giving Ty the cutthroat look over here from that point of view. So
I coached travel baseball a few years back when our sons were growing up together. That's how I got to meet John and Larry. And they knew I didn't like the Cubs, so the kids vote on the name of the team. What do you think it was? I had to coach the West Michigan Cubs for a couple years, and that wasn't right. I still think Hess was behind it all.
Well, you said when we first sat down, you had a Denny Mclain story that you wanted to share with us this morning. What is that?
Well, like I said, I've got to know Denny pretty good, and I went on quite a few road trips with him now, helped him do memorabilia shows, and went to Cooperstown, New York with him this year, and that was definitely an experience. Oh, but this is Denny. You want to go with Denny, you might as well just hold on because you're going for a ride. He called me, shot me a text, said, "Hey, you want to go with me to Rochester, New York, and New Jersey? We got a couple shows to do." And I said, "Sure." He goes, "Oh, stay in a 5-star hotel, all you can eat." He didn't tell me we were only going to sleep about one night out of four. We're in the car constantly traveling and eating is stopping and getting a bunch of Hershey bars and candy bars and keep moving.
It's all you can eat, though.
It's amazing. It's amazing the energy the man has. But we were in Rochester, New York. We finally get in really late, about 2 in the morning. We finally get to bed. 4 o'clock in the morning, we're on the 6th floor. And I got to push Denny around. He just busted his foot all up. He couldn't get nowhere. We're on the 6th floor. We shouldn't be on the 6th floor with a guy in a wheelchair. But the fire alarm goes off. So I'm like, what are we going to do? I mean, Denny's out in the hallway. I'm looking at him thinking, I can't carry him down 6 flights of steps. And I ain't going to shove that chair down. I was thinking, I'm going to have to drag his butt down the steps by his ankles or something. But finally, the alarm went off, so we didn't have to do that. But we didn't get no sleep that night. We go do a show at Rochester, the minor league team there. We head to Wildwood, New Jersey. We get to the hotel, and it's not handicap access. There's no way for me and Denny to get in. So we end up not sleeping. We ended up doing the show the next day. Finally, we figured we got about 4 hours sleep in 66 hours. Finally, we find a hotel out of town. We find this hotel. We get there, and Denny has to go to Walgreens. And when you go with Denny, you might as well know you're going to have to go to Walgreens and for sure Walmart at least once a day. Okay, so we go to Walgreens. He had to go get, I forgot what it was, something to do with his foot or something. I think it was antibiotic or something. But we went to the hotel. We checked into the hotel. Then we went to Walgreens. Well, we come back, and I'm pushing Denny around, and we're like, these room numbers ain't right. We're at the wrong hotel. And Denny's like, don't you tell nobody this. So till today, I've kept that one under my hat. But I was shoving him around in a parking lot at the wrong hotel that looked similar. But that's how we were disoriented. We probably slept about 5 hours that night and did the show and drove back. And but you know, and I think back on it, it was a great time this year in Cooperstown. I had a great time with Denny. We had another guy with us that was just Denny kept bouncing things off him. It was hilarious, but it was really you know, I mean, I know someday when I look way back, it's going to be like, wow, I was hanging out with the last 30 game winner and doing those kind of things.
At the Hall of Fame,
the Baseball Hall of Fame.
Well, Ty, I never hear anything negative about you and Wyoming Lee, no matter where we go, and it is a testament to you guys with this community and the tightness as to what it is. There's just something about it.
Well, there's definitely a tightness within the school. Our kids all know each other. It isn't like a senior, you know, bigger schools, the seniors know the seniors. I'll talk to people, you know this kid? And I'm like, no, you know, because the schools are so big. But at our school, it's, you know, everybody knows everyone. I mean, the eighth grade kids know the seniors, you know, and and there is a lot of family ties here. You know, there's a very tight-knit family atmosphere. And I guess I'll say it this way. The Hispanic community, they're very good family core people. I've always been really impressed with how tight they are with their families.
Yep. Well, Ty, I know you got a lot to do, and you're running around out there. You got the microphone that goes everywhere with you to keep everybody rolling. We just want to say thank you very much for the 11 years of this, but especially your time and dedication. and your genuine feeling for this community and these student athletes?
Hey, I grew up here. That's where I went to school, and there's no place I'd rather be. I mean, it's a great time. I still love the kids I coach. They're fun. Sometimes, you know, they tell you I can be a little harsh on them, and I can push them a little bit, but you know, I always push them hard, and I thank them at the end of the year for putting up with me. So
yep, absolutely. Well, Ty, all the best. We thank you very much.
Thanks to you and Doug and Gary and the people that have been coming out for years on putting this video together. When it's all done, it's pretty cool.
Yep, absolutely. Well, have a great rest of the weekend.
Thanks, Mike.
Thank you. Is going to close out the bottom of the ninth inning on another Stubby Overmire baseball card show here at Wyoming Lee. As always, it was a great event. The winners of the events are the Wyoming Lee Rebels boys and girls baseball and softball program and sports in general. A big thank you to first-time guest Jose Canseco, who is a huge compliment to the throng of people coming out here today. And as always, Denny Mclain pitched in his 11th consecutive game with us here at these events. We couldn't do it without either one of them. And Ty Amelander, another great season with it. As well as for Gary Vandevelde running the camera and producing and editing this. And Doug Hansen, we couldn't do it without you guys either. So for Mike Mall, all the best to you and yours until we see each other again. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the program. Testing 1, 2, 3.
Testing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold it there.
Right there?
Yeah, let's see what happens.
All right.
I'm going to test myself. Ready? Testing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, you just leave it there.
Yep, that'll work. Good idea.
I've done.
You've been around. You've been on a rodeo tour, haven't you?
Yeah. Been around the tour a little bit.
All right. Well, we are welcome here to, first.
We are waking up now. Retake. Edit.
That'll be on. You know that.
Fall in. Just jump in.
No. I don't trust you. Just introduce yourself. Introduce her. And go from there. Bro, I've got a jacket over there. If you're cold, we can put it on and do the interview. Not a problem. Now, Gary's camera just slid down, so he's getting a shot of it now, even. Ah, we had fun.
Was he? I got a Denny Mclain story we'll share here.
Oh, perfect.
He told me not to tell no one. I'm going to tell everyone.
After teaching 20-something years, you have kids walk up to you in the mall, and you're like, man,
do you remember me?
Yeah, I remember. Yeah, I do, but I can't remember your name.
You were the one that was always in the corner.
Yeah. Can you take that helmet home with you or not?
Boy, you guys are both trying to get me to go home in trouble with my wife.